in every Aero India, the Hindustan Aeronautics Limited is the center of attraction because of the range of activities that it does, and of course the new products and the new models that it churns out from its factory and its stable. But this time, particularly in 2017, HAL is the star of the show, and for that the credit must go to its chairman and managing director, Mr. Swarnaraju, who has given us some time in his busy schedule to tell us the plans of HAL and what it intends to do as far as the future planning in HAL's the inventory is concerned. So first up, HAL has suddenly come into its own, I would say, rather than being sort of always looked at as a poor cousin of the foreign manufacturers. What has brought this change?
HAL has always been manufacturer of this platform, either on the license or its own design. Looking at it, we have 15 our own designs and then 14 of them under TOT which were made. Practically we have 80% of the hold in the aerospace activities of the defense services in India.
Right.
While whether we are in the news or not, but then the services were to that extent ever since HAL is being in India doing their job since 7.5 decades.
Right.
The current focus would be possibly of on the HAL-40, the aircraft which is flying on to it, the first of its kind where HAL has funded it and then started flying on to it. Maybe it was in news for many days, so
right.
That bot might have been made you to surprise on. And now of course we are happy that aircraft is flying well. We are meeting our commitments, whatever has been made. And also, the new light, when you look at it, last 30 years, we are looking at LCA.
That's right.
One, media would definitely say that we have been working for 30 years. The LCA is not coming out, questioning the designers. Another way, HAL is there producing aircrafts for so many years, but it's not able to do anything to the LCA.
Right.
Without realizing the two different roles of.
Absolutely.
When after that we bought them together, we just had fruitful discussions with the customer and the designer as a production agency. We said, look, if the aircraft has to be delivered to the customer, HAL can produce an aircraft which would be purchased. I'm a commercial So let's go to the customer and ask his requirements furthermore to induct these aircrafts. And we had a fruitful discussions, and then some requirements are projected to us. Then the industry, HAL said, look, as the design is complete, ADA need not worry. HAL would like to invest and then meet those requirements with the customer in the interest of the timeline.
Sure.
So if you treat it as a design, it would have been many more years.
Right.
But if you treat it as a commercial activity, that give me this product, HAL has all wherewithal to go into the world, bring the requirements and integrate and give it.
Sure.
So that's how the understanding was struck, and you know that DSA has cleared 83 aircrafts acquisition.
That's right.
And by 2018 we'll demonstrate LCA with SR radar, SPG pod, refueling probe and a maintenance ease modification.
Sure.
So that's again news which you see. And also you see after 29 years the formation of LCA flown on Rajpath.
Right. First time, yeah.
So that's how in the domain, public domain would be seeing HAL is rocking.
You see, the perception matters, and therefore this perception is good for both HAL and the country, because you are a premier agency. Like you said, 80% of the jobs are done by you for the defense services. So are you going to ramp up the capacity to manufacture LCAs per year? I mean, is that also in your plan? Obviously.
Trying this, we've been saying this for last 1.5 years. The first question was HAL should ramp up its production.
Right.
Yes, HAL is ready to ramp up its production. For which production was the question?
Right.
LCA Mark 1, Mark 1A or Water Mark 2.
Yeah.
So then Mark 1A was coming forth, and we gave a proposal, we prepared everything ready.
Right.
We estimated about 1600 crores in the beginning. and we came down to about 1200 crores with 50% investment from HAL, 25% from Air Force, 25% from Indian Navy.
Yeah.
I understand the CCS note is sanctioned in the current month.
That's right.
Notwithstanding that, we have created the capacity of 8 and ready for 16. Mm. There are three ways we are looking at it. Number one, HAL itself is establishing the capacity of 16 aircrafts deliverable.
That's right.
We have offloaded the major assemblies to the private industry,
right,
like L&T, VEM Technologies, or Tokol, or these places where they can make, instead of making a treasury components, they can make a fuselage,
right,
front fuselage, center fuselage, rear fuselage, wing. That's have it. Been outsourced to 5 different Indian private vendors.
Now, that creates an ecosystem also.
Yeah, if they start supplying onto it, it is 16 plus.
Right.
And everybody knows that the industry can't turn over in overnight.
Of course
and
not.
We ourselves, I mean, Air Force, or no, aeronautical standards are pretty tough. Whereas
right.
We don't give any consideration for a failure.
Right.
And absolutely zero defect.
Sure.
So it's highly process oriented.
Mm. Exactly.
So these people may take about 2 years timeline to produce, but however, HAL has promised, being the lead aerospace industry, we are committed to create the ecosystem, hand-holding the industry which is willing to
right.
participate in the work of HAL.
Sure.
And to the extent that we install the jigs and calibrate the jigs, train the people until such time they deliver a product which is of the quality required by aviation industry.
Great. So you also have now the advanced Hawk coming to India, at least as a demonstration. What do you look at, how do you look at advanced Hawk process and the manufacturing in case you have to do that? And second question, follow up, is what about the helicopters? Because again, in your stable, some of these products are excellent and they are likely to be now taken up by the Indian Air Force and the Indian Army. How are you looking at that?
First, looking at the Hawk.
Right.
We have created the Hawk from raw material, and we have more than 100 Hawks in the Indian inventory.
Sure.
And as I every time say that these platforms have 30 years of life, and they give us two options to upgrade in between because of an obsolescence or an varied requirement or due to the technological developments. All along, HAL been a reactive organization. That customer comes and tells, look, upgrade my Jaguar.
Yeah.
So we did a Jaguar upgrade.
Or a Super U.
So today, having gained the knowledge in the Darin 2, created Darin 3, upgraded Mirage, makes HAL engineers are very confident in creating a design and fusing any sensor on any platform.
Sure.
They can pick up the products from the world market and then they're capable of fusing them. That's how Hawk is the first creation of the upgrade. Hawk I, India, we call it, is the 100th Hawk manufactured by HAL, funded by HAL, upgraded by HAL, being offered to customer.
And you flew that today?
It's a real thing that I could see physically, practically what's happening in the cockpit.
Mm-hmm.
Otherwise, we used to talk to the designers on the ground and say, no, we are going to create this virtual reality and all. So now I've seen the virtual as a reality in the cockpit.
Right, right.
So the Hawk gives us an opportunity of upgrading more than 100 Hawks. At the same time, looking at the requirement, if Hawk could be weaponized.
Right.
Weaponizing means it needs little more power,
sure.
A change in engine.
Mm.
When you change an engine to accommodate to the aerodynamics, the wing changes to be done.
So
that's where we signed an MOU with a BAES to,
right.
to create an advanced Hawk which would have limited war capabilities onto it than what is the Hawk Mark 132 was.
That's right.
So we hope there, we are very conscious that there is no market. Air Force said no, we are not interested. But then BA and we are together to create, and we have a hope that we will get the customers for it in the future.
And maybe an export market also.
Yeah, I mean, that's the hope, and the business does seem good for this, and the way the visitors are looking at it, and we are hopeful. Coming to the helicopters, advanced light helicopter, we have delivered more than 200 numbers in the ecosystem.
That's right.
And they are performing well. The customer is quite happy.
Right.
And on an average, we are logging in a serviceability of 65%.
That's very
And we are proud to deliver the first weaponized helicopter squadron to the Indian Army. And with regard to the ALH, we are expecting an order of 36 plus 41 helicopters in the near future. That could be a few days or a few months.
Right.
LCH has proved its weapon delivery capability during the Iron Fist. And its impressive aerodynamic performance made an order of a limited series 10 plus 5, 10 for Indian Air Force, 5 for Army, which could lead to an order of 163 plus. Okay, and we are ramping up and creating. We are, the board has given clearance for them to acquire procure the materials and then start manufacturing this 15 LCH before the order could be placed formally.
That's right.
We know that the A1 is sanctioned, so we're going to manufacture this. And coming to the LUH,
yes,
the 3-ton class, where we flew it on the 6th September 2016.
Right.
And the very fact that you could see in the air show leading the,
leading
the pack of rotary crafts of HAL stable
right.
on the formation flight on the first inaugural day.
Mm.
Gives us a very confident and hope that the numbers which are given in the AON would definitely be with us. That's 187. In addition, as a future development, we launched the 12-ton category.
Mm-hmm.
The mock-up is there in our stores, IMRH, Indian Multi-Role Helicopter.
Right.
And within 18 months, we intend to complete the preliminary project work of this IMRH
right.
and go into a detailed design and have a very clear requirement of Indian Air Force, Indian Navy, and then Indian Army. So that's from the stables of HAL. And the vertical of helicopters in HAL is pretty strong. So we have 3-ton, we have 5.5-ton, we're looking at 12-ton. So that completes the total range.
Yes.
And we hope to manufacture 1,000 helicopters in next 10 years.
Which is the requirement perhaps for the...
Which is very evident
yeah.
that I don't want to get you the numbers, but then they're always there.
That's right. No, but your plate is full, and we wish you, you know, all the best.
This statement I don't want you to make in public domain. Never ever an aerospace industry's plate is full.
Okay.
I hardly have a 46,000 crore order which gets completed in 2 years.
Okay.
And I need to survive for years, means I turn over 20,000 crores
every year.
So even 2 lakh crore is not good for my 10 years of life.
No, I
have Hawks closed, Sukhois are coming to close.
Right.
So
no, but let me amend that. Okay, I agree with your statement. Let me amend it that the plate is full as far as Indian military is concerned. But we are hoping that it should be an export oriented star of the country.
Thank you very much.
I'm sure you will do it with the kind of wherewithal that you have already gathered, and your engineers and your designers, and plus your leadership.
Thank you very much.
Thank you,
sir. Thank you. Sorry for hurrying it up.
No problem. We have to go somewhere. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Bye.